Hello, YouTube. I decided to make a quick little video about mouse traps because I remember Jev Chance had an eviction going. Ooh, you gotta watch these things. Okay, real quick. These are like the cheapest mouse traps you can get. I just found these in the corner of the garage when I first moved here. This house was vacant for like 2 or at least 2 years, and there was a little bit of a mouse problem. So I had to get kind of creative, and I caught every single mouse. Basically, what you do is you take the trap and you grab a box of kitchen matches, right? And you cut off the end of the match and you shove it across this, the part that trips where you're supposed to put the bait right here. But you dab each end of the match stick with peanut butter, and you'll be surprised. You're supposed to put these traps up against a wall because rodents like to walk, up against the walls because they feel, it's safer for them, So, if they just even brush up against this, it's like ultra sensitive, and boom. If they go anywhere near this area, they're screwed. So, these come in a multi-pack. They're like three or four for like $2. I don't know how much these are, but I'll show you the. These are the matches that I'm talking about. For those of you who are not familiar with matches, they look like that. You know? That kind of match. Okay, I'm being silly now. Alrighty. I'm in the process of insulating. This is not how you're supposed to use a product. It actually worked very well for me. I did this to another room. What I like to do is I like to put a layer of this between the beams and then put the R30 pink insulation on top of that. And then put another layer, and it just performs very well. And this is the garage, so it's really difficult to keep this room warm. I ordered a 5 gallon bucket of rubber paint from Ames Research, and everything that you see that cinder block, I'm going to spray paint it with this heavy rubber paint. I started putting some foam in a can insulation in there. I'm going to finish that when I get a chance. So I have a texture gun, Harbor Freight. I've never used it. I just bought it with the intention of using it, but I'm finally getting around to doing this. I also ordered a. Those are different size caps for here. Oh, yeah. Lucas products, I love them. Very good stuff. The injector cleaner, really good stuff. And that's just, when your engine's a little loose, that'll tighten it up. What was I gonna say? Oh yeah, I ordered a brand new electrical sub panel
just for the garage, because I intend to run a line from the main breaker panel, which is in the corner of the basement over there, and I'm going to mount the panel on the wall with the intention of it fitting underneath some wall cabinets where I could stock up like paint or whatever. I'm also going to upgrade. I'm going to this air compressor, it's not big enough for what I want to do. I want to get into painting. I definitely want to start painting cars and, you know, for my own personal enjoyment, whatever. Yeah. Just, my mind went blank here. Anyway, I'm hitting the record button the way, you know, VW Darren says. You know, I just, I'm not happy with how my garage is looking. I'm normally very, organized. But I've had to resort to hanging bags on the corner of, this is all electrical wires for cars, primary wire, you know, just wires and stuff, because I've been doing a lot of electrical wiring in the MG Midget. If any of you are familiar with the MG cars, you'll know that the electrical system is a nightmare. Yeah. See this bench right here? I just made it. This was an old countertop from my old house, and I just cut it short so that it's the same width as this shelf unit, so I could, you know, put it up against the wall nice. And this is glued down and screwed, glued and screwed to the wood shelf, the top wood shelf, and it's pretty sturdy. But I wanted to get one of those rolling tool cart chest things, so I could put all my air tools in the bottom, you know. And this air compressor, I have to get rid of it. It's so noisy that it just hurts to use it. It's a little pancake. Not the kind that you have for breakfast, but this is a noisy kind of pancake compressor. I don't like using this. It's just way too loud. And oh, and this insulation, Roxul, I think it's a Canada company. I love this stuff. Look at this. It is, oh, so much easier to work with. You just have to get used to it, because the first time I opened up the first package of this insulation, I just basically pulled it apart. You have to be very gentle when the way you handle it, but this is how I install it. I have this DeWalt blade, and what you do is you extend the blade out like this, okay? Then you can just cut the stuff. It just goes right through it, like, look at that. Very easy. Yeah, I just cut my insulation, but that's not gonna be a problem. You don't have to buy a special insulation knife. I've seen them online for like $30. Insulation, but like this stuff, I mean, you can just eyeball it. You don't even have to really use a ruler. Although I do, you know, you get yourself a nice straight edge and then you just run the blade down. But I mean, like with the pink stuff, because it's the pink insulation is so difficult to cut, this wall would have taken me three times as much to, basically what I'm trying to say is, this insulation, you can do a whole room, like, you can just bang it out. Because, like, the worst part of, in my opinion, the worst part about insulating is actually cutting the pink stuff. I hate it's just a pain in the ass to cut insulation. But with this stuff here, it's excellent. Oh, tripped on that box. Anyway, all right. This video is 10 minutes long. I'm going to shut it off because I'm just rambling. Hopefully this will be interesting to somebody, but whatever. Some of you guys think, you know, your videos are not interesting, and I think they are, so. Yep. I'm sealing the envelope. Spraying foam wherever I can. Well, maybe next time I'll do a basement tour, because that's where all my home projects are. And, yep, that's it. Alrighty, thanks for watching. Take care.